ideal sort of a segue into the back into the heart of the question about shared governance. Let me give you a really good example. Where does this university go in the next, say, 7 or 10 years? What are our directions? If the administration throws that to the board and says, okay, tell us what you want in 10 years. You know, this is not a full-time paid board. These are people who are giving sacrificially of their time and energy and resources to come and receive reports, vision with us, but they aren't paid. We're paid to be here. So we've been working up from the departments, up through the vice presidents, and up to the executive staff, and we have prepared a document that we will show to the Board of Trustees saying, this is what we suggest. This is what we see for 1, 5, and 7 year goals. This is what we see. The board would look that document over. We're just about finished with that. We're just putting the little finishing touches on that. We'll give that to the board. The board can say, we don't like this. Back to the drawing board. They could say, this is crazy. In high expectations, you cannot possibly meet these goals. They might say, come on, guys. You can do this in 2 years. You're talking about doing this in 7 years. Jump it up a little bit. Or they can tweak the dials. You know, okay, this one too low, that one too fast, whatever. But it means that they don't have to start from dead scratch. So we've been working on that for some time now throughout this second half of my first year here, preparing this document, which we're just now ready to present to the board. We don't have the authority or power to put that into effect. We can't pass, it's not a document we can pass. It's a document we can prepare, submit, and let them come back to us and give us suggestions. That's the checks and balances of shared governance and work in its best way. This is what the academic people think that they can accomplish in 7 years. This is how we pay for that. This is what we think enrollment will do, which is another way of saying this is how we pay for that. All of that has to mesh together. And this kind of engine is very, very complex. You're dealing with a $80, $90 million budget, and all these buildings and all these people and all this money and all these students and all these lives, that has to be meshed in some very, very complex gears have to go together to make that work. And you just don't want one person ruling by divine fiat. You want that to happen with the right people working in the right way. Is that helpful?